Now here's third and goal. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Rodgers now on third and goal. His favorite target, Travis Kelce, the intended receiver. And it brings up fourth down. So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get three to end the first half. From the left half, should be a fairly easy one here. And Tucker's kick right there, it's good. And they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. So they get three. They were hoping for six, an unlucky number 13 play drive.
Well, you go to the sideline after putting 3 points on the board, happy, but you wanted to be ecstatic. You wanted to have six on the board. On the opposite sideline, though, the defense, I think they're high-fiving each other, only giving up three after letting them run that much offense.
Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So as they take it over, we step aside. So here we go, first and 10 now. Final play of the half, it's Griffin. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll avoid the tackle there with a slide.
Yeah, that's perfect. Two, Davis, deep.
I gotta go. Okay, and sorry about that. Didn't know Larry got cut off early. We are back and ready for the third quarter. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that went. And the pressure will bring him down here. The Cardinals get home for the sack. Sheldon Richardson in there to get him for a loss of five. So the defense has put them in a tough spot. It's second and long. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Rodgers to throw on second down. Surveying the field. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
It's hard to believe when we look at the numbers that our statistician Marvin has given us about Aaron Rodgers today, that he's been held to this few. That's not normal for him.
And that explains the scoreboard, doesn't it?
It really does. As he goes, so goes his team. And he is just absolutely scintillating, but it's still not over for him yet.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up.
And he's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going.
Now Rodgers not pleased with the setup. He's going to take a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Down. The tight end Kelce has it over the middle, and he takes it down to the 10-yard line. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal. And they're going to speed things up here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And finding room to work, he's down to the 2-yard. Now here's a timeout defensively coming from the Cardinals. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. They come up in an offset eye. They'll give it to him right up the gut. They give him 2 yards there as they're set up now with a first and goal. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory.
Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. And that's going to leave him with just one timeout remaining still in the third quarter. We'll see if that comes back to haunt him. We'll be back. Sneak Rodgers, and the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. No gain, and it's second down.
Oh yeah, good surge defensively. Sometimes you can just tell by the way a quarterback lines his feet up behind center. He's going to try and sneak it in, and they catch him here and stop him for no gain.
And the eighth play on this drive coming up. They come out here in the eye. They'll run with Lynch. And he will take it in for a Falcon touchdown. Marshawn Lynch taking it in. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. And he'll put it through, and that evens us up at 10 apiece. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. One receiver left, two to the right. Now Griffin on first down. Left side here to Sanders. The completion good for three, and it's second down. Minute now of the third quarter. On second down, Griffin. And underneath here to McCluster. And he's out of bounds, able to take this one up to the 35. And they're definitely showing blitz here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's across the 40, 3 extra yards to the 43. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two.
And after that type of a run, there's some talking going on down on the field, but it's not trash talking. The guy who just carried the ball, he's going back and telling his offensive line, great job, keep it up, and we'll break that one soon.
And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three.
And that's the kind of run that gets everyone excited on offense. And you know, oftentimes the guys who carry the ball are the ones in the huddle doing the chirping. Right now, I think it's the offensive line telling them, run it again. We are right there about to break a big one.
One receiver left, two to the right. To throw is RG3. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs. And the offense lining up first and 10. So the D-line's going to spread out. They'll run it now out of the gun. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Give them 11 on the gain there. And it's good enough for an Arizona first.
And the tackle's made there by one of the secondary members. And I can guarantee you, having played that spot in the huddle right now or on the field, they're urging for a little bit more support from the guys up front. I actually remember one game where I hopped over a defensive lineman to make a tackle downfield and realized he was 10 yards downfield. That's not good. That's being driven off the line of scrimmage, and you can't have that if you're going to win a game on defense.
And he will get into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. Ezekiel Elliott, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Cardinals have taken the lead. And he was excellent on that drive. He deserved to be the one to get across the chalk.
Oh, I agree with you totally. A workhorse on the drive. And how about that last decisive run to punch it in?
The Cardinals set now to kick this one away, and off we go. So out come the Falcons now. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out. They feel good about themselves. They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
They go play action here on first down. Throwing left side, it's complete. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. On first down, Rodgers. Looking left side, he's got it, complete. It's a big play there for Atlanta. 41 yards.
That could not have been timed out any better, and that's exactly what receivers want. The ball in their hands as quick as possible. Allows them to catch it at full speed and take off and go. And how about the end result there? Big time run after catch yardage. That rack yardage is so valuable for any offense.
And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down. Second down following the run. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a 6-yard run, leaves him with about a foot or so here still to go to hit the marker with third down coming up. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play, and that's going to lead them to fourth down.
They gain nothing, and all they need are inches. Usually we put this on the offensive line, but sometimes it's the quarterback's fault as well on the sneak. You've got to get low and burrow.
Usually we talk about O-line surge, their D-line surge leading to fourth. Down 7, and they've got to go for it here on fourth down. Toss play to Lynch, and this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. That'll set them back with a loss of 3 on the play. And that should just about put this one in the win column for the Cardinals.